message of the Lord brought tidings to Mary, and she conceived by the Holy Ghost. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Behold the handmaid of the Lord, be it done unto me according to thy word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech thee, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that as we have known the incarnation of thy Son, Jesus Christ, by the message of an angel, so by his cross and passion we come to know the glory of his resurrection, through the same Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti, Amen. In tuoi volontari Dei, da inquilitifica e juventutum meam. Iulita medesa ricerca domem de gente non sancta, per nomine ene quod lo assorbe me. Quae tu est eus futi durum ae cuore de Christi, quarificis in cedur, dove figi meditus. Emita in lucem tuum veritatem tuum isum, et deducerunt, reducerunt, imantum sancti tuum, et tabernacula tua. Et in tuoi volontari Dei, da inquilitifica e juventutum meam. Confite putit in gitore, Deus, Deus meus, quae tristis anima mea, quare conturbas me. Sper in Deo corne met ocupit ebu ii, salutari vultus me, et Deus meus. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. In tuoi volontari Dei, et equilitifica iuventutum meum, auditor nostrum in nomine Domini, qui feci caelum et terram. Profitium Domini potentum, via Maria Sofia, via Tua Letargine, via Tua Libertistis, Sancti Postis, Prefus Pro, via Tua Anima, via Lugus, Santissimo, et Disfrate, Confitio Deo mi potente, via de Maria Sancti Vigini, via de Michele Arcangelo, via de Giovanni Battista, e Sancti Apostoli Spectri e Paolo, omnibus Sancti, se ti ricorda te, qui potrami nimis cogitazione, verbo et opere, mea culpa, mea maxima culpa, ideo preco beata, Maria Sancti Vigini, via de Michele Arcangelo, via de Giovanni Battista, Sancti Apostoli Spectri e Paolo, omnes Sanctos, et te, Pate, orari po me, ad Dominum Deo nostro. Miseriatum vesti in potens Deus, et dimissis peccatis vestis petuta et vos vita metana. Amen. Indulgeni sem sussionem et remissionem peccatorum nostrum in tribio ad nomis omni potens et misericus Dominus. Amen. Deus tu converso specificabis nas, et lepsu le capitor in te. Os ede nobis Domine misericordiam tuam, et salutare tuum da nobis. Domine exaudi ratione mea, et clamo meis et te bene. Dominus obiscum, et in spirito tuo. Ordine. Gaudeamus omnes in Domino, Deum festum celebrante, sub honor deviatit homem martyris, de cuius passione gaudent angeli et calautam filium Dei. Exultate justi in Domino, rectus Dei calutatio. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Gaudeamus omnes in Domino, Deum festum celebrante, sub honor deviatit homem martyris, de cuius passione gaudent angeli et calautam filium Dei. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Christe eleison, Christe eleison, Christe eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison. Gloria in excelsis Deo, et in terra pax omnibus bonae voluntatis, laudamus Te, benedicimus Te, adoramus Te, glorificamus Te, gratias agimus tibi propter magnum gloriam Tuam. Domine Deus Rex Celestis, Deus Pater Omnipotens, Domine Cui Unigenite Iesu Christe, Domine Deus Omnius Dei, Filius Patris, qui tollis peccatum mundi miserere nobis, Vitale spectatum di suscibe deprecationem nostram, qui sed is in dextram patris miserere nobis. Quoniam tu solus sanctus, tu solus dominus, tu solus altissimus Iesu Christe, cum sanctus spiritu in gloria Dei patris. Amen. Ex vobis et cum spiritu tuo. Ordebo. Deus procuius ecclesiae gloriosus pontifex Thomas gladiis impiorum occupuit, resta quesmus, ut omnes qui eus implorant auxilium petitionis suae salutarem consequantur effectum. Per Dominum nostrum Iesu Christum Filium tuum, qui tegum vivit et regni ad unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Orlebus. Deus qui salutis et tene beate Maria, virginitate fecunda, humanus generi premio praesisti, tribio et quesmus, ut ipsam pro nobis intercedere essentiamus, perque meruibus ancora in vite suscitere. Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum, Filium tuum. Ecclesia tue quesmus, nomine precius peccatus admite, utis luxis et precessasibus et gloribus universis, securit vi servi debitate. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum, Filium tuum. Qui tecum vivit et regni ad unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Lexit historiae beati Paulo Apostoli et Hebreos. Brethren, every high priest taken from among men is ordained for men in the things that appertain to God, that he may offer up gifts and sacrifices for sins. Who can have compassion on them that are ignorant and that err, because he himself also is compassed with infirmity, and therefore he orders for the people, so also for himself to offer for sins. Neither doth any man take the honour to himself, but he that is called by God, as Aaron was. So Christ also did not glorify himself that he might be made a high priest, but he said unto him, Thou art my son, this day have I begotten thee. As he saith also in another place, Thou art a priest forever according to the order of Melchizedek. Deo gratias. Ecce secedus magnus qui liebus suis placuit Deum, non est inventus similis illi qui conservaret legem excelsi. Alleluia, alleluia, ego sum pasto bonus, et conosco oves meas, et conoscunt me mei. Alleluia. Dominus obiscum et cum spirito tuo. Sequentia Sancti Evangelii secundum Ioannem, gloria tibi Domine. At that time Jesus said to the Pharisees, I am the good shepherd giveth his life for the sheep. But the hireling and he that is not the shepherd, whose own the sheep are not, seeth the wolf coming and leaveth the sheep and fleeth. And the wolf catcheth and scattereth the sheep, and the hireling fleeth, because he is a hireling, and he hath no care for the sheep. I am the good shepherd, and I know mine, and mine know me. As the Father knoweth me, and I know the Father, and I lay down my life for my sheep. And other sheep I have that are not of this fold, them also I must bring, and they shall hear my voice, and there shall be one fold and one shepherd. Laus Divi Christ. Ave Maria, gratia plena Dominus tecum, benedicta tu mulieribus, benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus. Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen. In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. Carissimi, beloved in Christ, welcome to this broadcast mass on this, the Octave Day of the Feast of St. Thomas of Canterbury, otherwise known to us, of course, as Thomas a Becket. He receives an octave in this country because of his former status as a patron of this kingdom, and also, of course, because of his place in history. He was born in 1117, the son of Gilbert Becket, a Saxon nobleman. He received education at Oxford, and then later, under the auspices of the then Archbishop of Canterbury, studied civil law at Bologna. He worked, as it were, in the medieval equivalent of the Metropolitan Police in London, rising eventually to become Chancellor of the Kingdom, appointed there by his friend Henry II, who also entrusted to Thomas the education of his son. Thomas proved himself ably both in service of the King and indeed of the Archbishop, such that he was ordained, made an archdeacon, appointed to the office of archdeacon by the Archbishop of Canterbury, and given the benefit, given the titles of various benefices. However, when the Archbishop of Canterbury died, Henry, who had already been in dispute with the Church concerning matters like taxes and glebe land and ecclesiastical courts, decided that he would recommend to the Pope the name of his own man, i.e. one Thomas Becket. So it was that Thomas was first one Saturday ordained, and the next Saturday consecrated and made Archbishop of Canterbury, though he had resisted this and forewarned Henry that their friendship may indeed be tested were he to accept the office. However, he was felt a duty and conscience bound so to do. So it was that, as Archbishop of Canterbury, the ongoing disputes again took up, but this time, of course, with the considerable knowledge and wit of Thomas pitted against his friend Henry. It wasn't long before their friendship was indeed tested. So it was that Thomas then went into exile, and in France, and Louis VII was very hospitable to him. The Pope was then in Avignon, and so Thomas went there to plead his case to the Pope. At the same time, of course, Henry had sent his own emissaries. The Holy Father, determining a more cautious plan of action, determined that Thomas should retire to a monastery in France for a couple of years, and this Thomas did. Meanwhile, Henry was brought to a more conciliatory mind. The Pope reinstated Thomas as his papal legate, and Henry accepted this. So it was that Thomas then returned to England to see and attend to his diocese, and to resume his duties as Archbishop of Canterbury. But this, he knew, would end in his martyrdom, for it is said that before he left the monastery, he'd seen a vision of the Mother of God, and she had presented to him a red chasuble, betokening the martyrdom that was to come. So it was that at Vespers in Canterbury Cathedral, on the 29th of December, just over a week after Thomas's birthday, he was born and named for on the feast of St. Thomas the Apostle, on the 29th of December 1170, at Vespers, Thomas was struck down by four knights who, seeking to win the favour of their king, had taken his cry of frustration about Thomas at court, "Who will rid me of this turbulent priest?" those famous words, and these four barons took it upon themselves so to do. He was struck at the altar in Canterbury Cathedral, and there, of course, he was buried. Very quickly, he was acclaimed a saint and canonized by Pope Alexander III in 1173. He died
as a martyr, for the rights of the church. He was defending the church against the civil authority, as it were, under the tyranny, one might say, of Henry II, who desired only to infringe upon the church's rights to increase his own material possessions. So it was that Thomas made that stand. But he was also making a stand, of course, for the kingdom of heaven. He was making a stand for the body of Christ, the church upon earth. He would, in later years, be followed by example in St. Thomas More, who himself too was beheaded by Henry VIII, another Henry, for similarly standing up for the truth, and standing up for the truth that the church herself is entrusted with. In Thomas More and Henry VIII's case, it was regarding the sacrament of holy matrimony. Thomas More refused to accept the divorce by Henry of Queen Catherine of Aragon, and for that he suffered and died in martyr's death. Now, in our own time too, my brothers and sisters, we might ourselves look to the examples of St. Thomas More and indeed St. Thomas Becket, because in our own time the church is enduring a form of persecution, not perhaps quite in the same, well, yes, actually, an infringement of her rights, so that you may know that we are no longer, the church is no longer able to run agencies or orphanages or find place with families for children in care, because the church refused to accept alternative forms of lifestyles is acceptable and for the benefit of children, other than the standard and ancient model of a father and a mother. For that, the church is no longer able to assist people in finding homes for children. Similarly, and soon, I'm sure, an infringement will begin to encroach, be the alteration by the civil law of the nature of marriage. Already there are attempts by individuals to force the government, to force the hand of the church to permit same-gender marriages. And also too, of course, there are limitations being placed upon the church in terms of being able to provide education for people of her own faith. Faith schools and church schools are being attacked. And similarly, of course, the church is not able to vocalize as much as she might her defense of the sanctity of life, particularly of the unborn, and also too against assisted suicide or euthanasia. In various ways, my brothers and sisters, the church still requires today champions to defend these rights, these inalienable rights, that afford and affect not so much any esteem or prestige for the church, but simply might enable her to properly, pastorally, and care for the faithful. Which is why, my brothers and sisters, we, each and every one of us who are baptized, should seek to defend the church and her policies, her wishes in these areas, in the public sphere, to influence those around us, in our families and friends. And though one appreciates that often this can be difficult, that we may have family or friends who are indeed living in different lifestyles, who have different ideas about the way people should live, who might have different ideas about assisted suicide or euthanasia, or indeed of the termination of unborn children, for all manner of reasons and excuses, and perhaps because they have themselves endured some considerable hurt touching upon these issues. Even so, it behoves each and every one of us in charity, in true charity, in sacrificial love, to seek to speak to and to change the minds of those around us, that they might come to see the truth of the gospel, the truth of the sanctity of life, the importance of recognizing life as a gift of God, as we reflected yesterday on the Octave Day of the Holy Innocents, and indeed of the importance of the family, looking for ourselves as a model to the Holy Family, to Our Lady and St. Joseph and the Christ Child. We've reflected since New Year's Day, since the circumcision of the Lord, upon how we might ourselves intend to, or make resolutions to improve our Christian discipleship in the year ahead. And today we might say to ourselves to steel ourselves to make a defense of the church, of the sanctity of life, of family life in the conventional sense, and indeed of the sacrament of matrimony, that we might prevent these experiments with unknown consequences from more adversely affecting certainly those who are vulnerable, those certainly who deserve and need our care and solicitous compassion, but who are being prevented by doing so because the church is being quietened in the public sphere. And this, my brothers and sisters, we should do motivated, as I say, by true charity, that we may bring others through our discourse to come to know and to understand the gospel of salvation, the gospel of charity, and indeed bring themselves and ourselves to the fullness of our redemption in Him who is God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen.
Dominus obiscum et cum spirito tuo. Parlemus. Passivisti Domine capite eius corona de lapide precioso, vita pensi in te, tribuisti ae. Alleluia. Frate, fratres. Suscipia Dominus, et officium in pace. Per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Dominus vobiscum, et cum spirito tuo, sus in corda, habemus ad Dominum, gratias damus Domino Deo nostro, dignum et justum est. Vere dignum et justum est decome salutare nos tibi sempre et ubique, gratias agere Domine Sancte Pater omnipotens et Deus, Deus, Deus Christum Dominum nostrum, Vergo e Mestatum, Tum lato d'Angeli, adorat dominationis, tremus podestates, Celicio runque vetutes, beate serafim, socius votatione concericam, concubus nocius voces utem et iu peste peccavur, supplices confei confessione dicere. Sanctus, 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 Dominus Deus Sabaoth, plenis in caeli et terra gloria tua, Hosanna in excelsis. Benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini, Hosanna in excelsis. Lo vi scopri per Però mi assicura securorum. Amen. Ordemus precepti salutaribus monachi divina istruzione com acta demus dice. Pater noster requiesi in cieli, sanctificetum nomen tuum, et veniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem, sed libera nos a mal. Terra omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Pax Domini sit semper vobiscum, et cum spirito tuo.
Ecce omnes Dei, ecce quitorit peccatum mundi. Domine non sin dignus, ut in tre se pecum meum, set entem de verbo et sanabitur anima mea. Domine non sin dignus, ut in tre se pecum meum, set entem de verbo et sanabitur anima mea. Domine non sin dignus,
ut in re subtectum meum sed tandem de verbo et sanabitur anima me.
Brothers and sisters watching Mass online and unable therefore to receive the Blessed Sacrament, we invite you now to make an act of spiritual communion, the words of which you will find below your viewing screen. My Jesus, I believe that thou art present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love thee above all things, and I desire thee in my soul. Since I cannot now receive thee sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though thou wert already there, I embrace thee, and unite myself wholly to thee. Permit not that I should ever be separated from thee. Amen.
Egus un pasto bonus, et conosco obis meis, et conosco me meis. Dominus obiscum, et cum spirito tuo. Orde. Ec nos communio Domine purgete crimine, et intercedente beato, toma matire tu acum pontifice, celestis remedii facie et exe consortes. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat ad unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Ardemus. Per humus omne operationem mysterii et vitia nostra pugentur recusit desideria compleantur. Refectionis sanctae nutritam gubernia Christus Domini tu applicatus Ecclesiam ut potentem adorazione directa et incrementa libertatis et cipiat et religionis integritate persiste. Gratiam tuum Christus Domini mentibus nostris ec nos communo Domini posit ad crimine et intercedente beati virgini de genetice Maria celestis et medii facet esse consortens. Periundum Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat ad unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Dominus obiscum, et cum spirito tuo, et in missa est, Deo gratia.
In nomine Domini benedictum ex hoc nunc et usque in saecula auditorium nostrum in nomine Domini qui feci caelum et terram, benedicat vos omnipotens Deus.
Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen.
In Dominus obiscum et cum spirito tuo sequentiae sancti evangelii secundum Matthaeum, gloria tibi Domine. In illo tempore defuncto Herode, ecce angelus Domini apparum et insomnis Iosef in Egipto, dicens, Suge ad Egipte puerum et matrem meus et vati in terram Israel, defuncti sunt enim qui per te, qui querebant animam pueri, qui consugens accepit puerum et matrem meus et venit in terram Israel. Audiens autem quod arce laus regnaret in Judea pro Herode patri suo, timiu et iro ire, et in monitus insomnis cecesit in partes Galilee, et venies habitavit in civitate, quae vocatur Nazareth, ut et incleretur quod dictum expo prophetas, quoniam Nazareus vocatur. Deo gratia.